Hello students, today we shall be learning about vegetative reproduction which occurs in flowering plants. Now, reproduction we already know about what is the meaning. So we'll see what do we mean by vegetative. Any part of the plant which doesn't undergo sexual reproduction is called as vegetative part. For example, roots, stem, leaves are the vegetative part of the plant, whereas flowers are the sexual reproductive part since it contains stamens and carpels. Okay, so the vegetative part which undergo reproduction is called as vegetative reproduction. We also call this reproduction as vegetative propagation. Propagation means to propagate or to multiply. That means with the help of these vegetative parts, how the multiplication of these plants can be done asexually. What are the different parts? Those are roots, stem, as well as leaves. So these structures are called as vegetative propagules. Okay, which will help in vegetative reproduction. So how do we define vegetative reproduction? It is the process of multiplication in which a portion or a fragment of plant body function as propagule and develops into an individual. So these vegetative propagules will develop later into a new individual. Okay, so that is called as vegetative reproduction. We should also remember that stem bears nodes and internodes. This is also a node. So in between the two nodes, there is internode. So nodes play very important role because it gives rise to axillary buds. What are axillary buds? Say for example, from this nodal part, we can get leaves, flower, as well as branches. Also the roots can emerge. For example, money plant, we have seen that even if we put this plant in the water, okay, with the help of this water or in the soil, from the nodal region, the roots or the rhizoids emerge. Okay, so nodes are very important, which are present only on the stem. They are not present in the roots. So we have to remember this part. Vegetative reproduction have two methods. One is natural method and another one is artificial method, which is done by the gardeners. So we'll see in the nature how natural mode of asexual reproduction takes place in flowering plants. So the first one, vegetative reproduction or propagation by roots. So we know that roots are underground. Okay, so they are present below the soil, in the soil. So here three examples I have taken: sweet potato, muraiya and dahlia. Muraiya ko hum curry leaves ya curry patta bhi kehte hain, hame maloom hai. Okay, so we see these plants. Okay, at the base of this plant there are many plantlets which arise. So ye plantlets jo ugte hain wo kahan ke hain, kis part ke part of the plant emerge hote hain? So that is the root. Okay, so root, though it doesn't have any nodes, but it can give rise to adventitious buds which will later emerge into a plantlet. Okay, another example is sweet potato or dahlia. Inko hum tubers kehte hain because it stores the food material in it. Okay, and it is edible. Now on these tubers we see some adventitious buds which are also called as slips. Okay, slips, that is slips, which will later on give rise to new plant. Similarly in dahlia hum dekhte hain ki new root tubers bhi emerge hote hain from the old root tubers. Next, वेजिटेटिव प्रोपगेशन बाय स्टेम पार्ट. यहां पर हम देखते हैं, ये मैंने यहाँ पे मेंशन किया है अंडरग्राउंड. सो देर आर सम स्टेम विच हेल्प्स इन वेजिटेटिव प्रोपगेशन विच आर प्रेजेंट इनसाइड इन द सॉइल. ओके, सो अंडरग्राउंड स्टेम हम देखेंगे. फॉर एग्जाम्पल पोटेटो, आईज ऑफ ट्यूबर. नाउ व्हाई वी आर कॉलिंग इट एज आईज? नाउ पोटेटो इज अ स्टेम, दैट मीन्स इट हैज नोड्स. नाउ दीज नोड्स दैट आर प्रेजेंट, those are called as eyes, they look like eyes, so that's why we are calling it as eye of tuber. Okay, so this potato we call it as tuber since it stores the food material and it is edible. So these tubers, okay, will give rise to small buds. यहाँ पे हम देखते हैं इस potato पर कितने सारे birds हैं. So these birds will give rise to new plant. सो फ्रॉम वन पोटेटो वी कैन गेट मैनी बर्ड्स. अगर हम इस पार्ट को कट करके सॉइल में अगर ग्रो करेंगे तो देखेंगे कि एक नया प्लांट मिल जाएगा हमें. सो लाइक दैट मैनी प्लांट्स कैन बी ग्रोन. सो फ्रॉम वन प्लांट अगेन विल गेट मैनी सच ट्यूबर्स. अगला एग्जाम्पल है राइजोम. नाउ एज द नेम सेज राइजोम, इट इज द हॉरिजेंटल part of the stem, okay, and it is the food material which is stored in the rhizomes too. Example hai ginger, turmeric or banana, okay. So yahan par hum dekhte hain ki ginger par nodes or internodes hai, and on the nodes there are scales like projections or scaly leaf like structures that are present, and those give rise to buds. So later on they will give rise to new plant. सिमिलरली हम बनाना प्लांट जब हम देखते हैं कि एट फ्रॉम द बेस देर आर मेनी प्लांटलेट विच विल अराइज, दैट इज बिकॉज ऑफ राइजोम दैट इज प्रेजेंट. अगला एग्जाम्पल है कोलोकेशिया, एंड द वेजिटेटिव प्रोपोग्यूल इज कॉम. ओके, सो इट इज द राउंड स्ट्रक्चर, ओके, विच ऑल्सो स्टोर्स द फूड मटेरियल. अगेन इट इज एडिबल. सो एट द नोडल रीजन देर आर मेनी डॉटर कॉम्स. Each daughter comb will give rise to new plant. Next is bulbs. Example is onion and garlic. Now onion, it is the edible part is the leaf part. It is fleshy leaf. Okay, it is modified leaf we can say, and that is edible. Now when we cut an onion, we see that at the base there is the stem, and that will give rise to new plant. Okay, so that stem will arise from the base. So at that region of the stem there are many bulbs will arise, small bulbs will arise, and each bulb will give rise to new plant. Similarly, this is the picture which shows the onion, and these are the bulbs, small bulbs which arise. Okay, so those have been taken out. And I have taken this picture just to denote the difference between the main onion and the buds. Same we see in the garlic. There are many cloves that are present. This is the main stem, but each clove will give rise to new plant. Okay, so later on when they grow, we will see that each clove will give rise to 5 to 10 cloves. Now comes vegetative propagation by stem, but it is subaerial, that is above the ground. Okay, so these are the different means by which vegetative propagation can occur in the nature. Runners or stolon. Example is strawberry or Bermuda grass. इसे हम lawn grass भी कहते हैं, और garden में जो grass पाया जाता है वो है cynodon, dactylon और Bermuda grass. So they grow vegetatively by runners or stolon. Now what exactly happens? The horizontal stem, okay, वो creep होता है soil पर, and at the nodal region there will be roots as well as small plantlet which will arise. So it is a creeping horizontal plant stem that takes root at a point along its length and to form new plant. So it will form a new plant and it spreads to the new niches, that means new area mein wo grow karenge. The main plant, even if it dies, still the other plantlets will survive because of this propagation. occur. Now this we see in chrysanthemum and mint. So here what happens is there will be the main stem. Now the stem which is present below in underground, that stem will little, it will grow horizontally and obliquely it will arise. So there will be many plantlet which will be seen above the ground. So shoot arise from the slender stem branch which arise from the underground base of erect main shoot. This is the main shoot, okay, and then the slender stem which will obliquely grow, okay, grow horizontally beneath the soil and then come out obliquely upward giving rise to leafy shoots. So it happens in chrysanthemum and mint. Next is offset. We see such kind of propagation in pistia and eucornea or water hyacinth. We see that these plants are aquatic plant which grow in pond or lake, stagnant water mein ye grow karenge. So it has the rosette of leaves. Now why we are calling it as rosette? Because they look like rose. So that's why it is named as rosette of leaves. Okay, and tuft of roots that are present below. Okay, so here you see there are the tuft of roots and these are the rosette of leaves. Now here offset, which we are calling it, there will be short internode. So at several point there will be the nodes which will give rise to leaves as well as roots. Next is vegetative reproduction or propagation by leaves. This is the well known plant called as bryophyllum and it is having great medicinal use. Now at the margin of these leaves, these are the notches what we call, and at the notches there will be leaf buds that will arise. So when this leaf is attached to the mother plant, what will happen? It won't grow into a plant as such, but when it gets detached from the mother plant, it will grow to new plant. So from one leaf, there can be many plants which can be propagated. Vegetative reproduction through bulbils. Here we can see these are the round structures at the nodal region, so it is subaerial, but we call these structures as bulbils. So they fall off from the main plant and it will give rise to new plant. And also this is edible, this bulbil. Example is Dioscorea. Another example we see that is pineapple. The fruit will have at the apical region of this fruit will there will be many bulbils which will arise. Yahan pe hum dekhte hain kitne sare bulbils hain. And also we see at the base. So each bulbil can give rise to new plant. One more beautiful example of agave plant. Hum inhe century plant bhi kehte hain. So on the branches there will be flower buds. Now flower bud is supposed to produce flowers, but here what happens, it get change to bulbil. That means flower bud will give rise to bulbil rather than giving rise to flowers. Okay, so those are the bulbils which we can see here on the branches. Those are modified flower bud which we can say, and each bulbil will give rise to new plant. So up till now we have seen that the natural method, how in the nature the propagation occurs. Now same method is used by the gardeners as well as horticulturists in the nursery, wherein they have applied artificial method. Same method they have taken, but since they are doing it, we call it as artificial method. As we know the role of the nodal region, so cutting can be done wherein only the nodal part will be taken and then many plantlets will be grown. So it can multiply also faster. So this method they are utilizing in nursery so that many plants can be obtained and it will be cheaper. And also much of concentration is not required, attention is not required to grow these plants. So different methods are grafting, layering, budding, wherein we see that even two different varieties of plants can be mixed, or we can make use of two plants and grow it together, such as here graft, how it is been shown. So we see in rose plants also there are two different types of flowers can be seen in one plant. Okay, so that is the method which is been used. So these are the different method: budding, grafting, layering. We had discussed about offset, runners or stolon. So that only procedure which is been taken and it will be followed in a large amount, so that more and more plants can be obtained. And since same type of plants are obtained, it is good that asexual reproduction or such propagation is been carried out in the plants. So that was all about the vegetative propagation, artificial as well as natural methods which we have seen. So we'll see now what are the key points which we should remember. First is prepare the flow chart, because flow chart is very good so that you will get all the types of the vegetative propagules, and also you will come to know what are the examples which will come under each propagule or type of the natural methods that are used in propagation in the nature. Then which are the propagules, whether they are root, stem, leaves or bulbils. Then and whether these propagules are underground or subaerial. Then examples of each propagules we should remember. So chalte hain MCQs ki aur. Eyes of potato tuber are dash. Now we know potato is a stem part, okay, and it is a tuber, so that the buds which we call it as, okay, which will give rise to new plant. So it is shoot, root, axillary or flower bud. It is the shoot bud. Okay. Vegetative propagule of bryophyllum. It is the leaf, the margin which give rise to leaf buds. Next, ginger grows from a vegetative propagule. Ginger is rhizome. Other two examples are which one? Banana and yes, it is turmeric. So which one is not a vegetative propagule? Anthrozoid, runner, comb or tuber. So we have already learned that runner, comb and tuber is the vegetative propagule. Anthrozoid is not, because it is coming under sexual reproduction. Okay, it is male reproductive part. Then such type of questions are also asked wherein the diagrams will be shown and then questions are asked. So identify the vegetative propagule. So potato, it is what? Tuber. Okay, and buds, those are the buds which we call. This is rhizome, bulbil and leaf buds. Type of stem modification seen in banana. It is a rhizome. Potato tuber is sown in a pot and the pot is placed in the freezer. What will happen? So definitely we should know in the low temperature none of the plant can grow properly. So definitely potato tuber won't be able to grow. A small portion of sugarcane stem between two successive nodes is cut. So what they are saying, these are the two nodes. Between the two successive nodes, a portion of sugarcane stem is cut and sown in the soil. So we are sowing this particular part, internode, into the soil. So what will happen? Will this piece of plant would grow into a new plant? No, because we know that internodes won't give rise to any root or shoot. Where? Why? Because nodes are important. Okay, which can give rise to axillary buds. It may be roots or leaves or shoot system. So here what will happen? Internode won't give rise to any plant. So that was all about this particular topic. I hope you all must have understood what are the different types of the vegetative propagation which occurs in nature. And next video we will see the terror of Bengal. Thank you.